let's take a look at the Nuggets opening lineup. Out on the perimeter, it's Caldwell Pope and Porter Jr. Gordon steps in at the four with Jokic in at center. And it's Murray in at the point guard position. And for San Antonio, sharing the wing spots, it's Vassell and Johnson. Then it's Jones. Then it's Freak. And it's Sohan in at the four slot. Now, here's Vassell. It's good with the assist that time from Johnson.
An emerging part of his game. Johnson's becoming a better playmaker.
Jokic kicks to Murray. And the pass to Porter. Gordon deciding where to go with it. Caldwell Pope for three. Drills it from outside.
And that's exactly what he's looking for. Draining the triple.
Pass to Sohan. Now, Vassell. Kicks it out to Jones. Passes it to Vassell. Pocket six. Over Caldwell Pope. Vassell, no good.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
And that one's good by Porter Jr.
And Porter's height and length around the basket's going to help him create opportunities to score.
It ended in the bubble, but how about the Spurs playoff streak? 22 consecutive seasons, Greg, coming to an end.
Kevin, making it every year from 1998 to 2019, winning five titles over that span, and having a slim head coach certainly helped that streak. So did having, though, a couple Hall of Famers.
Denver with the ball. After the basket by San Antonio. Pass to Gordon. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
And Aaron Gordon not hesitating because the defender was close. He just kept going.
And that outstanding drive and finish brought to you by Mobile One.
And putting that pressure on the rim. That's what it's all about, threatening with that attack.
Back to Jones. Spurs passing it around. Here's Johnson. Nice D from Porter.
Those are chances almost always you can rely on him to get you 2 points, but the D just enough to keep him out of rhythm.
Now here's Caldwell Pope. Here's Jokic. It's good.
I don't know if you knock Jokic off balance so much. You're just hoping that he misses something like that.
Jones, the best of the south. First quarter of basketball, just over 2.5 minutes play. And he's able to get it back. The Nuggets leading by five. And the points coming for them now, Greg, in bunches.
And we're seeing what a high-octane offense should look like.
Porter. That's in, coming off the assist from Jokic. Porter's got his second basket of the game.
And this is right around the time when one team might start to pull away.
Yeah, this team is looking to add to the lead, trying to put the other team away, and threatening here.
Wembanyama gets the bucket.
And I like to see this. They're calling his number early, and he's delivering.
Well, he's going to just keep going now. That's early confidence for him.
Now, here's Jokic. He feeds it to Murray. Jokic trying to free himself up. Murray, good.
Yeah, there's a feeling sometimes, even at 6'3", when Murray gets to the interior, he plays a bit bigger.
And San Antonio calls the first timeout of the game.
Trying to snap them out of this little slump.
Well, they can't find the net right now, and all they need, I think, is just to get one to go and get back on track.
Get on your feet and go wild so we can see you.
ends up going with a whole new group. First quarter of play, and just over 3.5 minutes in. Wembanyama passes to Graham. Here's Paige Diop. Out left to the wing. Shot clock at 6. They get it back. Wembanyama heads the bucket. Wembanyama has got 6.
Uncovered at the rim, finding cracks in the defense here early on.
Just really smart basketball and exploiting whatever holes that he's seeing right now in the defensive squad.
Now here's Bryant, the pass to Green. And here's Smith. Outside Bryant. Over Freak. Whoops, there's the 24-second shot clock violation, so they'll turn it over. Let's take a second look at that fantastic block.
And an early swat like that can really set the tone. Now the shooters will be feeling his presence.
Spurs trail by 5. Here's Graham. Pass to Wembanyama. Floats one up, and he sinks the layup. 8 points for him.
Good find by Graham there. Almost a sixth sense.
Outside, Green. This is it to Naji. Brown outside. He can't get that one. And San Antonio will go the other way with it.
Well, listen, if you're looking for a scorer and you're looking for a threat from the guard position, just look up one Devontae Graham.
This is his first free throw of the game.
Line for your Spurs, Devontae Graham. The line for 2.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
First one falls for Jackson. He's checked in for Denver. And good on the second, so he makes them both. Denver in the lead. Outside Bryant. He kicks it to Brown. And the dunk by Brown.
I don't know why we say this, but big men sharing the ball, we like that. It doesn't matter. Big, small, we'll take a good pass.
Spurs working the ball around now. Graham inside the line. And it's off the back rim. No good.
Well, he finds some space in that in-between gap there. Too bad he can't release that one on target.
Bryant the pass to Jackson. There's 10 seconds left to play in the first quarter. 6 on the shot clock. Basket is good. He'll get a chance for one more at the line.
Hard to shake Reggie Jackson when he's focused on scoring the ball. Awesome job staying in control through the contact.
The Nuggets shooting their first foul shot of the game.
And when you look at their numbers from a season ago, 80% as a unit, that's something you'll be happy with.
Misses from Jackson.
It's been interesting as Reggie has finally seemingly found a home, or at least confidence in the way he plays. He's a guy who can carry you on offense, and he will score in bursts, and those will be very loud points.
He Here's Bryant. No good on the last second attempt there. And that concludes the first quarter of play. Nuggets lead by five. And we'll get going after this from AT&T Center. Is where we're at right now. And a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for the Nuggets.
Tons of points off penetration so far, guys. They're driving at will on the defense, just taking whatever they want.
Well, in the early goings, the mid-range shot has also been working well for them. They've been racking up some points off of those jumpers, and those are probably being invited.
On the floor for Denver as we get going here in the second quarter. Gordon steps in at the four with Jokic in at center. Out on the perimeter, it's Caldwell Pope and Porter Jr. And it's Murray in at the point. Spurs trail by five. Outside, Jones. And stolen by Gordon. Here's Murray up on top, covered by Wesley. Fades back. Here's Caldwell Pope. San Antonio with the rebound.
One thing about Aaron Gordon that stands out is his insane athleticism. He's capable of some incredible dunks. And because he attacks that rim with such ferocity, it makes it special to see him go to the rim.
And with an update from the sidelines, let's check in with David Aldridge.
Thanks very much. Now, for 22 straight years, San Antonio made the playoffs. They haven't made the last three postseasons, and former Spur Robert Horry worries if they'll ever be relevant again, saying, I hate to say that. San Antonio is a small market. Guys just aren't going to go there. And that's a dire prediction for such a storied and successful franchise, Kevin.
Wow, no kidding, David. All right, thank you. We've seen Gordon compete, Brent, in the dunk contest, like you. And there are some who would say he should have won. What about you?
Yeah, you can make a strong case that he was robbed, and Aaron actually does. But we see that under the legs, leaping over the mascot dunk on so many highlight reels. Just a special athlete, and what a special contest that was.
Now, here's Porter. Gordon up on top. And he didn't get quite enough under that one. Spurs trail by three. Pass to Sohan. And the layup's good off the glass.
And there it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great inside position.
And a great job to get that angle on a tremendous drive.
And that's what a coach loves to see in a close game. Just put your head down and make something happen.
Now here's Gordon. Dishes it to Murray. And you talk to the great ball handlers, and they say, Greg, that footwork is an underappreciated aspect of it. Why is that?
It's like a dance. You're eluding the defender mostly with your feet. But the ball handling part is just making sure the ball comes along for the ride.
And he knocks down the first one.
Well, Jamal Murray at his size, the one impressive thing that stands out to me is that he will willingly go right at the defense.
The Spurs making a switch here. Graham's checked in. So Murray nails both of them. Spurs trail by three. Jones kicks to Johnson. And now approaching 2 minutes of action here in the second quarter. Here's Sohan, defended by Gordon. 5 to shoot. Wembanyama and Freak throws it down.
Extra on that one, fellas. Nobody's stopping that.
When he comes in there with that tomahawk, that's just too much force. Now here's Murray. Denver passing it around. Graham against Caldwell Pope. From deep, Jokic. Wembanyama with the rebound. Wembanyama has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Graham finds Johnson. Here's Sohan. Kicks it out to Johnson. And there's the pass to Graham. On the wing, Johnson. Sohan, the pass to Graham. Over Murray. And the Spurs scoring again.
And Graham and his quickness, that is making the difference for him to get shots off.
Jokic with it. Outside, Porter. With the fadeaway. And that one goes long. The Spurs have gone a nice 3-3 to start the second. Wembanyama gets the bucket. And now it's a 3-point Spurs lead.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Pass to Jokic. Over Freak. And Jokic with the basket on the assist by Caldwell Pope.
Trust me, Jokic feels very comfortable from that range there. His offensive IQ, off the charts.
Kicks it out to Jones. Back to Johnson. It doesn't go for him. Good defense by Jokic. And so it's Jokic with it. He brings it up for Denver.
And hey, what a career Caldwell Pope has had to this point.
He's been such a great complimentary guard. He just takes care of the ball. He shoots well all over the floor. He's a two-point threat. Certainly accepts the responsibility and the challenge defensively. He's carved out a career, and it's going to get longer.
San Antonio calls timeout.
Well, there's so much about Nikola Jokic that is special. Five man, it doesn't really matter any position, but his ability to crank out those triple doubles might just take the cake.
Five shots to fall in the second quarter. Outstanding shooting. Bates Diop. The basket is good off the assist from Graham. Graham's got three assists now in this one. The Nuggets trail. Brown outside. Passes to Bryant. Outside, Green. Brown outside. It's hauled in by Bates Diop. For San Antonio, they've gone 5 of 6 so far from the field in the second quarter. Vassell, the pass to McDermott, and finished off by McDermott.
Going to the rack with energy, and the D afraid to cut him off.
Yeah, gotta chalk that one up to some shaky defending.
There's some ways to get your coach's attention, and that draws the coaching staff's ire.
Now, here's Green. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Jackson kicks to Brown. From past the arc. Rebounded by McDermott. Spurs leading by three. back to the paint. Here's Bates Diop, and there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
Total letdown by the D. Can't leave the bucket unprotected.
Absolutely, and it attacks an easy 2 points onto the lead.
Will not find a higher percentage opportunity than that.
Here's Najee. Pass to Green. Fires from 14. Graham with the rebound. 3 second difference between shot clock and game clock. And the call is going to be. Yes, yes, it is. An illegal screen.
When a pick like that is questionable and creates that much of an advantage for the offense, you have to blow the whistle.
Yeah, a quick little lean like that is going to get the ref's attention. Foul call.
12 seconds left now here in the second. Smith inside. Bank shot. No good.
He may not be the strongest inside presence in the league, but still, he's got to convert from there.
So that'll be it for the first half. Fairly even battle underway in this one. It's San Antonio
23
as they wrap up the second quarter with a massive 16-6 run. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much here with Greg Popovich. Pop, what did you see in the first half?
We have ball movement. You know, we weren't in mud. Guys were in attack mode. Nobody held the ball. You know, you pass, catch, or shoot. And we did that a lot in the first half.
Yeah, you had them swiveling, Coach. Thanks for your time. Back to you guys.
Thank you, David. And we'll be right back after halftime to start the third quarter. See you in just a bit.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, basketball fans. What a pleasure it is to bring you into the 2K studios again. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. A pretty close game for the Spurs throughout the first quarter. They were in a rough spot down 7 at one point, but kept it from getting worse than that. They were able to take control in the second quarter and finish the half ahead by 5. Kenny, what was your take on San Antonio?
It's been an aggressive approach for them at the offensive end. Getting the ball inside and getting as many points as possible close to the rim. So far, so good. They have a nice edge in the points in the paint.
And big fella, let's get your thoughts on the Nuggets.
Fellas, just a total lack of effort on the board. I'm not getting technical, and I never really do. It's all about heart, wanting the ball, hunting the rebound. If they were better in that area, they'd probably be winning this game. I'm just saying.
And now with the second half about to get underway, let's send you back courtside. See you, everybody, with Kevin Harlan.
For you thus far, a pretty evenly contested game. You look at Freak in this game, guys, he has been everywhere.
In those first two quarters, he was pretty much an automatic bucket getter if he got it down low on the block.
Yeah, we'll see if the double teams start to come here in the second half to make them adjust offensively, but he's going to keep going at them.
Second half of basketball upon us. We may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game it's been so far. Sharing the wing spots, it's Vassell and Johnson. Then it's Freak, then it's Jones. And it's Sohan in at the four-man position. That's the San Antonio five. That shot wide open. Jokic has got the first points of the third quarter up on the board for the Nuggets. The pass to Wembanyama. Shot is good off the back rim and in. 14 points for Freak.
Yeah, here's a list of things I don't want to do, and right at the top is guard that guy.
Outside, Porter. Denver passing it around. Pass to Jokic. Over Freak. Kept alive. Gordon, the pass to Jokic. And the shot goes down. Jokic has got 9 points.
Good job reading the floor. Aaron Gordon solid at sensing when someone's open.
Jones kicks to Vassell. On the wing, Johnson. Porter pulls it in. Nuggets have gone 2-4 here to start the second half. Pass to Caldwell Pope. Back to Porter for the lead. Here's Gordon. It's good. This game is all even. 6 points for him.
Aaron Gordon's athleticism can show up in other areas. That time, track down the offensive board.
Here's Sohan. Pass to Vassell. Johnson outside. Just five to shoot. Jones kicks to Vassell. Off target from outside. Denver's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Greg, Devin Vassell came in as a 3-and-D type player, but he's grown beyond that.
He has added secondary ways to contribute on offense. Still, not a great shot creator, but can finish plays in a variety of ways to help his team.
And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. The Spurs have looked good at the line. They're perfect in four attempts.
And they were 75% from the line a season ago.
Taking two shots.
First free throw is good. San Antonio making a switch here. Graham's checked in. So 1-for-2 that time at the stripe.
And you can sense that the pressure might have gotten to him a little bit, but he did do enough to put them in the lead.
The Spurs have gone 1-of-3 since starting the second half. Inside, and Freak throws it down.
And he's an automatic finisher when he gets into that area.
He is, and he picks the simple one-hand stuff to get the 2 points. Now, here's Porter. The pass to Caldwell Pope. And Aaron Gordon gets the whistle that time. That is his first foul of the game. Database Diaz checked in for Michelle.
Now into the lineup for your Spurs. Database Diaz.
So it's Johnson who brings the ball up for San Antonio. 3-point lead. Jones dishes to Graham. Johnson outside. Beyond the arc. They get the rebound. Wembanyama. He's still up. Now he is 9 of 10.
They didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Wide open look here for Murray. Rebounded by the Spurs.
So weird. Sometimes when you get that much time, it can throw you off just as much as having no time.
Offensive rebound. That one goes. Count it. Wembanyama has got the lead up to 7 now for the Spurs. Timeout is called. First of the game for the Nuggets.
And coach can't be happy, and I think I know why. Their defense putting up no resistance inside.
No, they're not preventing them from scoring, and if you can get to a high efficiency shot on the floor, and that's the paint, you just keep going.
Side. Brown feeling it out a bit. Back to Smith. 6 to shoot. shot to stop the run. Wembanyama with the rebound. Wembanyama has got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done.
Bruce Brown. First personal foul.
And let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for San Antonio.
They've been playing some really physical offense, just attacking the paint as much as possible. And I tell you what, they have been very successful with that strategy.
And you want to talk about ball distribution? They've been dominating that aspect of the game. I think there's a bunch of bankers out there. They're dropping dime after dime.
And he makes the first. No good on the second free throw. The Nuggets trail by 8. Puts it up from 15. San Antonio with the rebound. Wembanyama has got 10 rebounds here tonight. So active. Pass to Bates Dion. The offensive rebound. Second chance shot, Wembanyama heads the bucket.
And that's a lesson for the D. Fight harder on the glass.
Yeah, you just can't afford to give up second chance opportunities again and again.
Denver calls timeout. Freak really making a difference here.
And they simply have no answer right now for what he's doing to them. He is making them pay.
Nothing on the scoreboard yet. Good ball movement here by the Nuggets. Back to Smith. Shot clock at 6. They could use a bucket. Drains it from beyond the arc. Smith's got himself on the board with 3 there.
You can't just stop when there's a pick set up. Gotta fight over it as a defender.
That's one that the coaches will watch tomorrow with that player. You hate to see him give up that situation.
Here's Smith following the bucket by the Spurs. Pound kicks to Smith. Jackson in the corner. Smith against Wesley. They get a hand on it and stolen by Freak. 5 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Passes it to Bates Dion. That one good for 2. And now an 11-point Spurs lead.
Now how about how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
Jackson looking it over. The kick out to Brown. With 1 on the clock. Offline. And so it's the San Antonio Spurs holding on to an 11-point cushion as we get ready to take a break. Their defense has been active and effective. And we'll be back with you shortly. There may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. San Antonio leading by 11. So out there for the Nuggets right now. The forward spots will be Porter Jr. and Gordon. Murray and Caldwell Pope, the guards. And it's Jokic in at center. Chalk up two there.
Another good play. This is how they built the lead, calling on the right guys at the right time.
Basketball IQ is something that gets talked about, but it's importance to a team showing up here, running plays that turn into scores.
And it's the Nuggets with the ball. After the basket by San Antonio, outside for Caldwell Pope. Pass to Gordon. Six on the shot clock. There's the pass to Murray. Sinks the triple.
And perimeter scoring, I have to imagine it was a topic of discussion at halftime.
Maybe trying to find a little bit more space and ball movement to get guys open at the three-point line.
The Nuggets trail by 10.
And always a smooth athlete. KCP doing a better job of drawing contact.
Second personal foul. First team foul. Shooting for Denver, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, two shots.
Take a break, two shots.
He's off on the first.
Yeah, much improved foul shooter. KCP also starting to get to the line at a higher rate.
Vassell, he's checked in for San Antonio. And the second free throw, good. Spurs leading by 9. On the wing, Johnson. Pass to Sohan. Now here's Jones. Passes to Johnson. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Launches it. Denver grabs the miss. Jokic has got 6 rebounds now in the game. And that one's good by Porter.
And you really want to step up and try to make Porter make a move right there. The three ball look easy.
On the wing, Johnson. Over to the left wing. Wembanyama. Good. It's Johnson with the assist that time. And it's now 26 points for Freak.
I tell you what, I don't know what he did in the locker room, but he needs to do a little bit more of it because he's on fire.
Caldwell Pope passes to Jokic. Down low, here's Porter. Takes the assist and lays it in. Picked out the pass nicely. Porter's got 5 points now this quarter. Time called here. The Spurs decide to talk it over. Some time to check in from the sidelines. You got for us, DA?
Well, guys, during the last break, I listened to Greg Popovich talk to his team. He said, I want us to play as though we're behind. We're good when we play with urgency. We're bad when we become complacent. Don't become complacent. Let's go. Guys?
Thank you, David. The Nuggets trail by six. Caldwell Pope outside. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
When you get inside, there's all kinds of traffic. This is the result as Porter Jr. is going to get to the foul line.
At the line for the Nuggets, Michael Porter Jr. at the line for two.
Shooting two.
That free throw, no good.
And Michael Porter Jr. continuing to be pressed off the floor with these injuries to get himself righted back and healthy and make contributions at a high level.
No luck that time either.
That's a strange trip because typically he's pretty much money from there.
Drives to the hoop. Here's Vassell. It's good.
If you give him an inch of space, he's going to make you pay.
And so it's Jokic with the ball. He brings it up for Denver. Jones against Murray. The kick out to Porter. Odd pass to Gordon. And then Gordon with the dunk.
Great timing, but Aaron Gordon's going to make any lob look good.
San Antonio leading by six. Pass to Sohan. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
Second,
it's going to be on Aaron Gordon.
And with the offense getting right to the rim, at least they save the layup.
Sohan. Two shots.
Two.
That free throw missing. And he's good on the second. The Nuggets trail by seven. Murray scanning the floor. Fires from 18. Here's Porter. That's another one for him. His fifth in just seven shots.
And Porter stepping up once to take that shot.
Johnson outside. Quarter of play, and over 3.5 minutes have gone by. Vassell kicks to free. He gets that one. Wembanyama has got 16 points here in the second half.
They're loving the confidence. Just rise and be free, and you know you can do this.
There's something to be said about knowing yourself. It allows him to shoot and shoot comfortably, even with taller defenders out there.
Jokic, it's tipped. Now, here's Vassell. He's guarded by Caldwell Pope. Jones dishes to Johnson. Now the pass to Vassell. Jones with it. The second chance effort, and a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. It's going to be on Jamal Murray.
Personal foul. Second team foul. At the line for your Spurs, Trey Jones. The line for two.
gets the first, and that stretches their lead to 8. He's off on the free throw, unable to get that second one to drop in. Caldwell Pope with a wide open look. Good, and a nice assist from Porter. Porter's got 3 assists now in this one. Spurs leading by 5. Jones looking for an opening. Johnson against Porter. Johnson's shot is off.
That's the kind of D you need when he's got the ball near the hoop. They were all over.
Pass to Jokic. Got it! What a beautiful shot to bring him to within 3.
Jokic stepping up big time here.
Jones kicks to Johnson. Driving the lane. Nice D from Porter.
And there hasn't been anything easy for him in this period.
No, I haven't seen him in comfortable spots, or at least spots we've seen in this offensive set that are allowing him to settle in.
And Jokic is the leader of this team. He's not someone you want to foul in these spots.
Shooting for Denver, Nikola Jokic, taking 2 shots.
First one drops, and that brings them within 2 here.
And Jokic just has that presence out there. Never looks like he's feeling any kind of pressure. Just that calm demeanor really helps him in these clutch kind of moments.
And Jokic drops them both.
And I want to think twice before sending him to the line again. He gets locked in when the game gets close.
Pass to Johnson. No good, unable to end this run.
Well, after an impressive first half, he's just not been able to get the room or get anything going here in the second.
And just no fear, guys. I mean, he is willing to mix it up in the paint with the big boys.
And that's an intentional foul.
Yeah, you can't let him hold the ball and just look those 5 seconds away.
At the line for your Spurs, Devin Vassell. Taking 2 shots.
Good on the first, and that will put them up by 2. Tough break as his second attempt at the line, no good. Murray, the pass to Jokic. Over Freak. Oh, missed it. And so it's San Antonio who's straight by with the win. That was a fun night of basketball. Fabulous finishes. They continued to wait out until the very last moment to seal.
And there are so many times when you see these tight games won at home, that advantage of having that crowd behind you oftentimes is the ultimate X factor.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast.